Now, when I have an audio file and I erase it from the mix window or the edit window, it's not going to be erased from the file. I actually have to go into this side menu by clicking this little tab thing on the bottom right side. It's going to open up an audio file window. This has all my audio files within the session. There's only two files up here, but for some reason it has a bunch of other ones there, because that's because it doesn't erase anything. So if I wanted to actually delete this file, I could just press delete, but it'd still be there. If I actually want to delete it from the session, what I can do is actually highlight it like this. It's actually going to show which one it is on my right side. It's actually this first audio file right here. So what I can do is go here and clear this file. Clear the selected one, right? I could either remove it from the session, or I can remove it from the computer completely by pressing delete. If I want to, I could also erase all the extra audio files. There's a lot of audio files that aren't being used right now. So what I could do is I can select all the unused regions, and it'll select everything else that's not being used right now. Everything besides these two, and I can actually clear it. I could remove it from the session, or I could delete it from the hard drive. Either one.